sisters to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span. Sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، brothers and sisters, welcome to all of you to a new edition of your program Correct Your Citation. I would like also to welcome our studio guests. Assalamu alaikum and thank you for joining us today. And as usual, but with a little difference, inshallah, we'll begin by reading the ayat, which will explain their meanings, and we'll practice the recitation, inshallah, in the second segment. But the difference is I will be reading this ayat today, inshallah, azza jal, from ayah number 13 through ayah number 20 of Surah Al-Hashr. And Al-Hashr means the gathering.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لأنتم أشد رهبة في صدورهم من الله، ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون. لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر، بأسهم بينهم شديد، تحسبهم جميعا وقلوبهم شتى، ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يعقلون. كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا، ذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم. كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان اكفر، فلما كفر قال إني بريء منك، قال إني بريء منك أخاف الله رب العالمين. فكان عاقبتهما أنهما في النار خالدين فيها، وذلك جزاء الظالمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله، إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم، أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون.
Before we begin explaining the meaning of this beautiful ayat of Surah Al-Hashr, I would like to take a look at our word bank, and we have a few vocabulary to study. The first one is in ayah number 13, the word rahbah. لَأَنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ رَهْبَةً فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ. الرَّهْبَةُ means the fear. And it also means fearful or awful, which means in general that the Jews, Bani Nadir, and their allies fear you more than they do fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll explain why. And the next vocabulary, you've got two words to provide us with a complete meaning, which is قُرًى مُحَصَّنَة. إِلَّا فِي قُرًى مُحَصَّنَة. Ayah number 14. Al-Qura means townships or cities or towns or villages. And muhassana is taken from hisn, which means fortified. So they do not fight you on the battlefield. They hate the confrontation. Rather, they only fight from behind fortified townships or villages. The next word is ba'suhum, still in ayah number 14. Ba'suhum, which means their ba's. And the ba's means enmity, and it means violence. So ba'suhum, their enmity amongst each other. They are not, as you guys think, they are not united. Rather, they do have big deal of enmity amongst themselves. Wabal. ذاقوا وبال أمرهم. In ayah number 15, ذاقوا وبال أمرهم. الوبال means the evil result or the bad consequence. عاقبتهما. The outcome or the end result for both of them. And here it refers to the end of both of الشيطان and the one whom الشيطان misled. كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان كفر. So the next ayah says that their outcome, their end result for both of them, for الشيطان and the one who follows الشيطان, أنهما في النار خالدين فيها. The next word is الفاسقون, from فسق. الفسق means rebelliousness and disobedience. So الفاسق is a singular, the subject, the person who is rebellious or disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فاسقون is in its plural form, those who are rebellious, the rebellious ones. The last vocabulary we have is ayah number 20, and it is the last word in ayah number 20 describing the traits, the attributes of Ahlul Jannah, the dwellers of paradise. Ashabul Jannati هم الفائزون, plural of فائز from فوز, which is success. So الفائزون, those who achieve success, the truly successful one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ali Imran, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ. The one who will be dismissed from fire and will be removed away from the fire of hell and makes it to heaven, enters heaven, فَقَدْ فَازْ, has indeed achieved success from الفوز, which is success, and that is the ultimate success. So now back to the ayat and their detailed meaning. We're still talking about بَنِي النَّضِير. بَنِي النَّضِير and their fate, what happened to them and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tortured them on the hands of the believers, and they were expelled from Al-Madinah due to their treachery and their plots against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Muslimin. And afterward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threatened them with a severe torment in the hereafter as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated a fact in ayah number 13. He says, لَأَنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ رَهْبَةً فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ. This is really strange. The Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that these guys, the Jews, fear you, and you cause fearful and awful fear in their hearts more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does. They fear you more than they do fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because they know that Allah's torment isn't soon. It will be in the hereafter, on the day of judgment. So they count on that. That's why they said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَا النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَةً. This is what the Jews claim. They said that even after they claim that نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَأَحِبَّاءُهُ, we are the chosen sons of God and we are His most beloved. They said even if He were to punish us on the day of judgment, لَن تَمَسَّنَا النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَةً. The fire of hell will not touch us but for a few days, 7 days. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَتَّخَذْتُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَهْدًا. Do you have a written document? Do you have a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will treat you likewise? Of course not. بَلَا مَنْ كَسَبَ سِيَّئَةً وَأَحَاطَتْ بِهِ خَطِيئَتُهُ فَأُولَئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. Indeed, one who earned a sin, particularly disbelief, this is the biggest sin, وَأَحَاطَتْ بِهِ خَطِيئَتُهُ, and his sins surrounded him and besieged him. فَأُولَئِكَ, such people are the losers, the opposite of the winners, and the successful ones would be Ashabul Jannah. Great. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ. So they fear your punishment. They fear that you be victorious. You will kill them. You will kick them out. You will punish them. More than they do fear the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they do not comprehend. Had they comprehended, had they understood the word of Allah which was revealed to Prophet Moses, they were all have been united on one thing, which is belief in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fearing Allah and acting according to what Allah has revealed to Moses, peace be upon him. Furthermore, he stated a fact which we still experience with the Yahud until today, and it will continue until the Day of Judgment, which is, لا يقاتلونكم جميعا. They never fight you all together, إلا في قرى محصنة, except from behind or within fortified cities, fortified townships. بأسهم بينهم شديد. You may think that they are one unit. They're very powerful. They support one another. This is not the case. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in their breasts. بأسهم بينهم شديد. They're divided. They have a great deal of enmity amongst their sects and divisions, amongst each other. بأسهم بينهم شديد. Look at this. تحسبهم جميعا وقلوبهم شتى. You may think that they are united. No. قلوبهم شتى. Their hearts are divided. ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يعقلون. This is because they are a people who understand not. كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا. As a matter of fact, with regards to the previous ayah, you can look at what's going on in Palestine. These guys keep building walls after walls, fences after fences, and fortified cities after fortified cities. They spend most of their money and the money which they rip off from the Western countries to build these walls. Why? To isolate themselves. They fear the stones and the rocks of the little kids. لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر. So they hit a run. They shoot from a distance. But they do not dare to confront their enemies, whether Muslims or other than Muslims, on the battlefield or face to face. They are not into that. So this is what they did in all the battles with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Banu al-Nadir, and afterward the Battle of Khaybar, as we'll get to speak about it, inshallah, and so on. And as a matter of fact, one of the signs of the Day of Judgment, as in the Hadith, this is what's going to happen. They will also fight from fortified townships or cities and from behind walls. كَمَثَلِ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ قَرِيبًا. So we've got ayah number 15 and ayah number 16 will provide us with two beautiful and accurate examples. This is called al-amthal or parables or examples. The parable or the case of Bani al-Nadir in their conflict with the Muslimin, and the case of al-Munafiqeen and in their false support to Bani al-Nadir are presented in these two consecutive examples. So the first example says, كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا ذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم. They are like their immediate predecessors. whom? The Jews of Banu Qaynuqa', and you know what they did? And accordingly, they were exiled as well and evacuated from Al-Madinah. They suffered. فَذَاقُوا وَبَالَ أَمْرِهِمْ. So they tasted the evil result of their bad and evil conduct. That's not it. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And awaiting for them in the hereafter, on the day of judgment, when they stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of reckoning, a severe torment. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Because of their disbelief. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them taste the torture and the humiliation in this life, in addition to عذاب أليم waiting for them on the day of judgment. Okay. So they misbehaved and they showed misconduct and they betrayed their promises and covenants with the Muslimin, similar to those of their predecessors, who soon, a few months ago, a year ago or so, were evacuated and were humiliated because of their treachery, the Yahud of Bani Qaynuqa'. Then the second example, or the second method, in ayah number 16, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides the example of the likeness of the Yahud under the of the Munafiqeen under the leadership of Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul in their false support to Bani Nadir, when they said, لَئِنْ أُخْرِجْتُمْ لَنَخْرُجَنَّ مَعَكُمْ وَلَا نُطِيعُ فِيكُمْ أَحَدًا أَبَدًا وَإِنْ قُتِلْتُمْ لَنَنْصُرَنَّكُمْ. In ayah number 11, they made promises and they made covenants with the Jews of Bani Nadir. Don't worry about it. We'll support you against Muhammad. We'll not let him kick you out or exile you. Even if you have to fight, we will stand next to you and will fight against Muhammad. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ أَنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. And Allah bears witness that the munafiqeen are liars. They will never do such thing because they do not dare. They cannot do it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this fake support that al-munafiqeen showed to Bani Nadir is exactly similar to how the shaitan deceives the foolish people of the human beings. كَمَثَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Exactly like Satan. إِذْ قَالَ لِلْإِنسَانِ كُفُرْ. When he kept after al-insan, any insan who obeys him and follows his evil whispers. قَالَ لِلْإِنسَانِ كُفُرْ. Disbelieve. Commit this sin. This is good for you. I promise. You're going to enjoy it. Just one sip. Just one cup. This moment is so beautiful. This date, you cannot miss it. This earning is good for you. So he deceived al-insan. He led him to disbelief. كَمَثَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِذْ قَالَ لِلْإِنسَانِ كُفُرْ. And then what happened? فَلَمَّا كَفَرْ. So when the insan, when the human being, or whoever follows the whispers and the footsteps of a shaytan and disbelieves, فَلَمَّا كَفَرَ قَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِنْكَ. He disowned him. A shaytan disowned him and said, I have nothing to do with you. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. Because I fear Allah. You disbelieved on your own. I did not have any authority over you. I did not force you to commit sins. I did not force you to disbelieve in Allah. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Can you imagine the shaitan sets up the person, then after the person is already fully in the trap, and he takes him to his fate in the far of hell, وَالْعَيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, and he dies in a state of disbelief, he says, إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. I fear Allah, the Lord of everything that exists. So this is similar to how the munafiqeen deceived the Yahud of Bani Nadir. And when it was a serious time, they disowned them. They ran away. And they let them face their fate on their own. They did not even lift a finger to defend them. فَكَانَ عَاقِبَتَهُمَا. So the outcome of both of them, of الشيطان and those whom الشيطان misleads or deceives, أنهما, that verily both of them, الشيطان and his followers, في النار خالدين فيها, they both will end up in fire, والعياذ بالله, eternally they shall abide therein forever. وذلك جزاء الظالمين. And that will be the consequence of the wrongdoers. The worst kind of ظلم, brothers and sisters, is disbelief. يا بني لا تشرك بالله. This is what Luqman said to his son while he was advising him. My son, don't you set partners to Allah in worship. لا تشرك بالله. إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. The greatest ظلم, the greatest oppression and injustice is to set partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship. So the result and the compensation and the consequences of ظلم and disbelief is to abide eternally in the far of hell والعياذ بالله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد. Then all of a sudden Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now turns to the believers and he addresses us with the greatest advice, which he advised all the prophets and the righteous ones. وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. We've indeed advised and enjoined upon the people who received the book before you and you as well that you should do taqwa to Allah. Fear Allah and keep your duty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Why? وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ. And every person should examine his deeds. What have you prepared for the morrow? The morrow which soon will come is the day of judgment, the day of reckoning. So the advice of taqwa is to examine your own deeds and actions, actions and sayings. What did you say? Good or bad? What did you do? Good or bad? What did you believe in? Good or bad? So the person should hold himself and herself accountable before he or she will be held accountable. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. One more time. In the same ayah, he ordered us to do taqwa. At-taqwa is defined by the great Imam and Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah have mercy on him and may Allah be pleased with him as, At-taqwa hiya al-khawfu min al-jaleel, wal-amalu bit-tanzeel, wal-istidadu li-yawm al-raheel. When somebody reminds me saying, Muhammad, ittaqillah, I should say, Allahumma ij'alna min al-muttaqin. Oh Allah, make me among them. This is an advice. You should not feel ego. And you should not feel you are above the reminder. Every person is worthy of this advice. This is how Allah advised Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all the prophets and the righteous ones. And he advised all the believers. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqu Allah wal tanzur nafsun ma qaddamat lighad. Then once again, wattaqu Allah. And fear Allah and keep your duty to Him. Prepare for the morrow. Prepare for the day of judgment. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Because indeed Allah is fully aware and well acquainted with all of what you do. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنفُسَهُمْ. And don't you be like those who forgot Allah. How would one forget Allah? By being disobedient to the commands of Allah and the guidance of the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم by being negligent. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. In Surah Taha, those who will turn away from the guidance in the Quran or the previous books, he will be resurrected as blind. قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا. Why did you resurrect me blind? I used to see in the dunya. كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا. فَنَسِيْتَهَا. Thus our ayat, our guidance, proofs and evidence have come to you. And نَسِيْتَهَا does not mean you forgot about them. You neglected them rather. You ignore them. You turn away from them. So نَسُوا اللَّهِ, they neglected His commands. They acted as deaf and blind. We don't want Allah's command. We know how to run our life and our affairs without His help. نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنفُسَهُمْ. As a result, the consequence of forgetting about Allah and being disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made them forget themselves, to forget their righteous deeds, to forget that they should be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They forgot to prepare for the day of judgment. They forgot to prepare for themselves on a day where money would not help. Even if the person would have the possessions of the whole earth, gold, it would not help. It would not be accepted from him, even if he has it, as a ransom, to free him from the far of hell. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنفُسَهُمْ. And he made them forget themselves. Let them forget to be righteous to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And such people as are أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. They are the truly rebellious ones. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة. They are not equal. They are not even. Whom? أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة. The dwellers of fire والعياذ بالله and the dwellers of heaven. They will never be equal. They will not equal nor even in this life nor will they be equal in the hereafter. They were obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya and they will be in the eternal delight in the hereafter in al-jannah. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة. أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون because the dwellers of al-jannah will be the truly successful one. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. Brothers and sisters, let's take a short break, a couple of minutes, and inshallah, Azza wa Jal will be back to continue with you and listen to your beautiful recitation. Stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Ask Hoda.
If you're still in Mecca or close by to Mecca, then you have to know that you are still in the state of Ihram. As long as it is not for sale, then he does not have to pay zakah for it. Forbade praying witr, similar to Maghrib prayer. So whoever prays witr three rak'ahs and sitting after the second rak'ah as if he's praying Maghrib prayer, this is forbidden, this is haram. To euthanasia is permissible with animals, but not with human beings. If an animal is suffering, killing an animal for a legitimate reason is permissible. Both are acceptable, but the majority say that after the rukur is the place of qunut. But both was reported.
Have a question or concern on your mind? Hoda TV decided, based on popular demand, we will be bringing you an additional episode of Ask Hoda with Sheikh Azim bin Luqman Al-Hakim live from Jeddah, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, narrated that when Allah, glory be to him, wishes good for someone, he bestows upon him understanding of the religion and that Allah makes the path to paradise easy for those who seek knowledge. Preoccupied by work or family in the modern world, a Muslim may struggle to find time for acquiring Islamic knowledge. To ease this struggle, we are launching Hoda Academy to be your gateway to online Islamic e-learning.
Enroll now and study from our renowned scholars. Learn Aqidah from Dr. Muhammad Salah.
Learn Fiqh from Dr. Hatim Al-Hajj.
Learn Hadith from Dr. Muhammad Saeed.
Learn Tafsir from Sheikh Ibrahim Zidane.
And learn Arabic from our professional instructors.
Successful graduates of Hoda Academy will go through a final test and eventually receive a certificate of completion.
To enroll and learn more about Hoda Academy, please visit us online at hodaonlineacademy.com.
Hoda Academy, your gateway to authentic Islamic knowledge.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and welcome back. Our phone numbers are as usual, area code 002-0238-555-248-249 and the email address is tajweed@huda.tv. We have our first caller tonight, Abu Aisha from United Arab Emirates. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
كيف الحال يا أخي؟
الحمد لله لا بأس عليك.
الحمد لله شكرا. بارك الله فيك. Today we're reading from ayah number 13 of Surah Al-Hashr. This is page number 547.
Okay, that's fine. Thank you. I will go ahead.
Please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر بأسهم بينهم شديد تحسبهم جميعا وشتى ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يعقلون كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا ذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان فلما كفر قال إني بريء منك أخاف الله رب العالمين فكان عاقبتهما أنهما في النار خالدين فيها وذلك جزاء الظالمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون.
حسبك ما شاء الله يا أبا عيشة، بارك الله فيك، جزاك الله خيرا. Very good. Maimuna from Nigeria. Assalamu alaikum. How are you?
I'm fine.
Great. Alhamdulillah wa shukrullah. Maimuna, go ahead and read from ayah number 18, which begins with Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqullah. Okay. Begin, يا ميمونة. Begin. Go ahead, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
طيب حسبك يا ميمونة، جزاك الله خيرا. Thank you. بارك الله فيك، ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله، جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم. طيب بارك الله فيك. We'll turn to our studio guest Ahmed. السلام عليكم. From آية number 13, and I would like to confirm once again when I say the number of the ayah follows the ayah. The ayah does not begin with a number. So when I say ayah number 13, for instance, in page number 547, then I'm talking about لَأَنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ رَهْبَةً فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Please, Ahmed.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لأنتم أشد رهبة في صدورهم من الله ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر بأسهم بينهم شديد تحسبهم جميعا وقلوبهم شتى ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يعقلون كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا ذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان اكفر فلما كفر قال إني بريء منك إني أخاف الله رب العالمين فكان عاقبتهما أنهما في النار خالدين فيها خالدين فيها وذلك جزاء الظالمين
حسبك يا أحمد جزاك الله خيرا ما شاء الله بارك الله فيك We have Amir from United Arab Emirates السلام عليكم يا عامر
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
كيف حالك؟ الحمد لله go ahead and read from آية number 18 please يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله
نعم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنسوا أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون
هم الفائزون
هم الفائزون
حسبك بارك الله فيك يا عامر جزاك الله خيرا حبيبة from Nigeria السلام عليكم حبيبة
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
How are you, sister?
Fine, الحمد لله.
Go ahead and read from آية number 13, please. لأنتم أشد رهبة.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لأنتم أشد رهبة في صدورهم من الله ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر بأسهم بينهم شديد تحسبهم جميعا وقلوبهم شتى ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يعقلون كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا ذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان اكفر فلما كفر قال إني بريء قال إني بريء منك إني أخاف الله رب العالمين فكان عاقبتهما أنهما في النار خالدين فيها وذلك جزاء الظالمين.
حسبك يا حبيبة، جزاك الله خيرا، ما شاء الله، بارك الله فيك. I have no comment on your citation other than mashallah is so good. Barakallahu feek. Ihab, go ahead and read from ayah number 18, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ittaqullah ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون.
حسبك يا إيهاب، ما شاء الله. Where have you been hiding? إيهاب actually works for Huda, and this is the first time to hear your citation. ما شاء الله. From now on, you lead the prayer, though. طيب، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سمير، كيف الحال؟
الحمد لله.
Okay, you got your opportunity to recite now from ayah number 13, please.
Inshallah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لأنتم أشد رهبة في صدورهم من الله. ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر بأسهم بينهم شديد تحسبهم جميعا وقلوبهم شتى ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يعقلون كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا ذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان اكفر فلما كفر قال إني بريء منك قال إني بريء منك إني أخاف الله رب العالمين فكان عاقبتهما أنهما في النار خالدين فيها وذلك جزاء الظالمين.
حسبك، بارك الله فيك سمير، جزاك الله خيرا. We have Uthman from Nigeria. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
How are you Uthman?
How are you?
الحمد لله وشكر الله. بارك الله فيك. I want you to read from ayah number 15. كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا. نعم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. كمثل الذين من قبلهم قريبا ذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان اكفر فلما كفر قال إني بريء منك إني أخاف الله رب العالمين.
عثمان
فكان
عثمان can you hear me? Okay. A couple of things in this ayah, ayah number 16. Number one, the ta of the word as shaytan you have to distinguish it from the ta. كمثل الشيطان. Okay, that's number one. So it's not الشيطان. الشيطان. Number two, the fa in the word كفر is mere ضمه. There is no واو. There is no مد. So I will say, إذ قال للإنسان كفر. Not كفور. Okay? Read this ayah again, please.
كمثل الشيطان إذ قال
الشيطان
كمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان اكفر فلما كفر قال إني بريء منك إني أخاف الله رب العالمين فكان عاقبتهما أنهما في النار خالدين فيها وذلك جزاء الظالمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون.
May Allah make us among them. Jazakallah khairan, ya Uthman. Hasbuk. Jazakallah khairan. We have the last caller from Nigeria as well. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Okay. Go ahead and read from ayah number 13, please. We only got a minute and a half. لأنتم أشد رهبة في صدورهم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر
It's very obvious, Sister Amatullah, that you are calling from an internet and also you're listening to your recitation. And unfortunately, we ran out of time. In addition to that, phone call was disconnected. So by that, we come to the end of today's edition of Correct Your Citation. By the end, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this humble effort from all of us, brothers and sisters. Until next time, I leave you in the care of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.